go like this to the camera.
Wait, were you adopted?
Look, put your nose on my nose. See?
I try.
Hey, what up? It's your boy Mellow Downs, and on today's Cover Corner, I have a very, very special guest, Mana Wahine, musician, TV personality, and radio host, I believe.
Model as
model.
Well.
Anika motherfucker Moore.
Yeah.
How are you, sis? Up? I'll bring it in.
Killed it out.
Level one.
Hi.
Yeah, and shout out to guys Wakanavu who sent this to me all the way from Fiji.
So, thank you, guys. Don't give me toast time.
No, I'm not.
But do, because I need a little buzz. 10 in the morning buzz, eh?
Yeah, just make you feel a bit relaxed.
Okay. Tastes like dirt, eh?
Yeah, I'll give you a small one.
Yeah, just a small one. I'm easily susceptible to drugs. Do we do cheers?
Yeah,
or is it like, malo?
We just say malo.
Fai fai fai. Malo. 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 Oh. Oh, do you have to scull it?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I'll give you a smaller one next time.
Okay. Okay. I like the aftertaste. I don't like the immediate taste, but I like the aftertaste.
Yeah, cool.
I just have this little bit.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
Nice, cool. So where did you grow up and what was it like for you growing up?
I was born in Papakura and I grew up in Christchurch with my mum, who was a solo mum. Mm. Christchurch is, back in the 80s and 90s, it was quite hard being Māori, half caste, growing up there because it was... racist. Just extremely racist, and I got called everything from bunga to nigger to lazy doll bludger to it was a pretty wild place. But the thing I loved about Christchurch was the music industry was not an industry, just these amazing musicians that you could all hang out with, like you know, your Lady Sixes, your Scribes, your Beck Bodunga, you know, a lot of musical influence was.
So were they around during like when you were growing up and stuff?
Well, not your Becks and your Bows because they're a little bit older than me, but Lady and I used to, we used to go to the Ducks Deluxe and Lady's cool and I'm a geek and I used to try and rap around her and she'd be like, I'd be like, yeah, and she's tall too, so I'm like this little squidgy little Eminem girl. Yeah, motherfucker, jibbuckle. And then she'd be like, no. And I'd be like, bye.
How did you get into music and where did it all start for you?
My mum and my dad, both musicians. Mm. My dad, blues, jazz. Wow. My mum, more your Ruby Turners, your Randy Crawfords. And she loves George Benson.
Wow.
And she can play like him, you know. So I grew up with music in my whānau and I... from day dot knew that I was going to be a musician.
Wow.
I just always had the passion, learnt the guitar. No one taught me. I was really, really persistent about my own, you know, longing to be a musician, even when I was 13, 14, 15. I was always in the school plays. I was always just practicing every day.
Yeah, yeah.
I always say to people, they say, oh, how do you become a musician? Oh, what do we do? And I say, well, first of all, stay home and practice. It's your passion, so you have to just practice and practice and practice. Did you get John Campbell wasted?
Yes.
God, he would have
and
talked
Patrick Gower.
Oh, he would have loved that because he did that marijuana documentary.
He wanted more. Like we finished, and then the project pulled up, and then we had some more. I was just like, wow.
Yeah. Well, those journalists, they go hard and fast.
They do.
So just keep that. You have the rest. As you can see, I'm a big softie when it comes, or big pussy when it comes to things.
Sweet, cool.
But I do like cocaine, so if you've got any...
Oh. Yeah, so what was it like signing to a major label like Atlantic in America? And what was that like for you?
I was 18.
Shit.
It was 1999. And it was extremely exciting.
Mm.
But... I wasn't actually ready for the journey that they wanted me to do.
Yeah.
So I recorded my album in New York and I was only 19 living there by myself. My manager
by
was
yourself.
Yep, and it was so amazing. I was just had the best fun and got a little fake ID it's 21 to drink, and just went out and just lived my life and experienced, and then wrote about those experiences. Yeah. Recorded in a dungeon, a basement underneath a building on Christopher Street, which is the gay street. Mm. And it's just down the road from the Friends, where they show the outside of the Friends building.
The cafe, yeah.
Well, not the cafe, the actual building.
Yeah.
So I used to walk past there and be like, someone told you love was there. Like, I'd always sing whenever. And then I saw them filming Sex in the City all the time. Wow. And I would be such a loser, I'd just be standing there going, oh my God.
A bit extra.
And trying to get in there, but they wouldn't hear.
But yeah, what were some disheartening things about being signed to a major label and you being so young and things like that?
I think what they want from you and what you want from you are different things. Mm. Major labels, I mean, I don't think there's hardly any around in New Zealand anymore, but they sign you for you.
Mm.
So look at you, you've got beautiful dreadlocks, you've got a beautiful face.
Oh, thank you.
You're all exercise-y gear. What's this?
Just
basketball. But, you know, then if you were to sign to an American hip-hop label, they might try and change the way you look.
Yeah.
And that's what they tried to do with me. Lose weight. I was skinny anyway. Mm. Even to the point of trying to get me to write certain songs.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bitch, I just wrote these songs and use like these ones, so release these ones. Like, why would you sign me if you're not going to... I've had my other friend, Holly Smith, go through the same thing too, where their expectations didn't meet up with my expectations. But I have to say, I've only dealt with really kind people in record companies. Like, I've never had a bad run-in.
Like someone evil, like.
Yeah, there's no, yeah, I mean, there yeah. was one kind of evil person, I won't name names, but he had a good intentions, and he wasn't evil, he was just gang-ho. Oh,
okay.
Gang-ho?
Gang-ho.
Gangbusters.
Gangbusters. Gangbang, no.
Sorry, this cover's turning me into a hip-hop artist.
What were some of the cool things about being signed to a major label over in New York, being, 19?
They give you lots of money and you get to go anywhere. They flew me anywhere I wanted and got picked up in limousines, but that wasn't cool. It was just the free sparkling water.
Wow.
They'd have sparkling water in all the limos and I'd be like, fuck them, flesh, sparkling water. Like, that was my go-to.
And were you, just living in an apartment by yourself, or
living in an apartment by myself, shopping, hanging out in East 14th and 3rd, and hanging out with a lot of expat Kiwis as well.
Yeah.
But I did enjoy it when I moved back to New Zealand because I'm a real home girl. Aotearoa is my flavour. Yeah.
Because you're a musician, can we hear a little a cappella for some of these people?
What do you want to hear?
Anything you want to sing?
Okay. Can you give me a beat?
Oh, wait, hold up.
Ha ha ha, yeah. I'm with Mellow Downs, we're drinking cava air, and I think I'm stoned, I don't care. I gotta pick up my kids from school and kindy. Yeah, I feel like Mork and Mindy.
Oh. Bars!
No.
And saying that.
I'm embarrassed.
You're good.
I'm blushing. Oh, I'll drink the rest
of this. Yeah, that's all good.
God, you go hard with your cava.
I'm just used to it.
I can't keep up with you rap artists.
I'm just used to it. It tastes like earth.
Oh, maybe I should give up drinking just to cover. I'm not going to.
You're super open about your experience with motherhood and I love how you choose to share the challenging aspects as well as the good. What's the funniest thing one of your kids has done recently or said to you?
Oh, they say funny things to me every day, like, Mama, can I play the PlayStation? I'm like, ha, that's funny. Do your chores first. No. My son, Soren, I woke up the other morning and I was like, just woken up.
Yeah.
Fresh as a daisy. And I walked in the lounge and then I was like, morning, son. And he was like, poo, Mama, did you fart? And I was like, it was my morning breath that he didn't like.
Shit.
And I was like, sorry, so I went and brushed my teeth. Little shit.
What are the most difficult challenges you've experienced in motherhood recently?
I have to say, do you have any kids?
No, I just got a pit bull.
Okay, well, it's hard. It's you know how being a musician's hard, marketing yourself is hard, writing a song can be hard, but being a parent is the hardest thing I've ever done, but also the most rewarding thing I've ever done. Kids are hard, and you have to... You learn a lot from them and you change. I've changed as a parent. I'm not so I don't know, I just feel like I've really opened my heart to parenthood and to all my kids. And, you know, you sometimes lose it at your children, and that's just like life, and then you learn not to, you know, you know? I just talk to them normally, like, can you please not hang off the deck? Or can you please wear undies, you know? Or can you please stop eating all the food? Because mama needs to work and you're eating all the food. And I have to do more jobs.
Yo, do you remember the first time your kids saw you on TV? Or like, how did you explain to them, like, oh, I'm on TV and radio and whatnot?
Oh, no, kids don't care.
Yeah.
They like literally, if they see me on TV, they're like, oh, like PlayStation, or like, kids don't actually care who you are, as long as you feed them and don't beat them. Yucky.
Shit, where's the weirdest place you've ever played a show?
People's weddings.
Oh, really?
Because it's like, it's really intimate and you're like the paid performer. Yeah, I've done like millionaire weddings and then just normal people, backyard weddings. A ship, a really old frigate ship that then they blew up, and now it's in Wellington thingy, Waters.
Yeah. Is it a bar?
Yeah, well, some ship underwater and you can dive and shit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was weird.
And what's the strangest ACOM you've stayed at on tour?
Okay. Do you know Chicks Hotel in Dunedin?
I think so. Is it
old? It's an old, beautiful stone hotel. It's not strange. It's more like haunted. Mm. And there's lots of rumours about, you know, a woman got shot in one room and a baby died in another room. It's very, very scary to sleep in. So when we go on tour, I bring entourage so that we can all sleep in the same room, because I'm scared of everything.
But do you guys have to stay there?
I choose to, because I love it. I love the whole touring around New Zealand and staying at different freaky, out-of-it places.
Yeah, I remember one time I played in Kapiti and the promoter didn't have ACOM, so he was like, oh, you're staying at my grandma's house? But she wasn't there. And then I was like, sweet, it was like three of us. And then, like, as you do, you bags the biggest room, you know, like the first one in there. So I was like, oh, yeah, sweet, I got this master bedroom.
Yeah.
And then I was like lying down, and I was just looking on the wall, and there's all these like old photos of old people, and I felt like they were just staring at me.
Oh, I bet you didn't sleep all night.
Yeah, I was like, oh, fuck that, I'm going in the lounge. And so we just like Marae styled it.
Yeah, keep yourself safe in numbers kind of thing, eh?
Yeah. Who were your musical influences like growing up and stuff?
Because I'm a singer-songwriter, I really, really loved Fleetwood Mac. That was my biggest band. The Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, because my brothers played it all the time.
Yeah.
But mostly Alanis Morissette, Jewel, Lisa Loeb, like all these just classics, women, Heather Nova, Sarah McLachlan, and that's how, I mean, I used to have an American sound to my songs when I first started because I was listening to American artists. But on the other end of the spectrum, I'd be listening to Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg. Me and my mum would clean the house to What's My Motherfucking Name? Like, na 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 na. Mum, I'm vacuuming. And she'd be like getting into it. And it's like, you know, so we've got the kind of homey side. Do we call ourselves homie these days? Is that still cool?
Yeah, it's fine.
Homie side. And then you sing a songwriter, geeky, girly, white girl
side.
So it's
like a balance.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, that's cool.
Well, I'm half caste, so.
Yeah. What's your iwi?
Ngāpuhi, Te Aupōuri and Te Rarawa. Up north.
Whereabouts up north?
Pāuranga, Hokianga.
Yeah,
on the west coast. Kind of rough and rugged and beautiful. And I love it up there because, you know, my feeling about that is when you pass, you wander along the beaches up there until you get to Cape Ranga, and then you jump off back to go back to Hawaiki.
Yeah.
And whatever Hawaiki means to you. So it's really spiritual for me when I head up north.
Yeah.
I feel my father, who's buried up there, my granddad.
Wow. All your ancestors.
All my ancestors, yeah. What's your dad's last name?
Wehungi.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's a Wehungi.
Because
you
look like me, like you've got the nose and the
cheekbones. Yeah.
And that's what we all look like. Well, some of us look like up north, so we're probably whanau.
Probably cousins.
Yeah.
Oh, true cousins.
Yeah. Want to get married? That's what they do.
Yeah, straight up.
No, they don't.
She's doing a mother shot.
I'm liking it now. That's cute. No, I'm not.
Who are your top five artists that are alive?
Amy Winehouse.
Mm.
Try to make me go to rehab. They try to make me go to rehab too.
No.
I should. That's a real, real, real hard one. Can it? Probably John Lennon. Just because of, I didn't mean to hurt you, and I'm sorry that I made you cry. Oh, do you know that song? It's called Jealous Guy, and it's so good.
Probably. I'm a bit wavy on this cover now.
That was 2A.
Yeah, maybe just 3.
Okay.
Keep it easy.
Amy, John, and Stevie Nicks.
Oh, nice.
Okay, I'll just stop it there.
What kind of songs do you play under the DJ? Is it Unica or Anika?
Oh, Uniqua.
Uniqua,
it was years ago, and we had a funny group, and we used to get played on BFM a lot, and we had a song called Nothing Matters Anymore Since I Left My Fucking Whore, and that was a big hit.
It actual group, or wasn't you just playing out?
No, I used to DJ, but my DJ's like, play the iPod and then go out and smoke.
Yeah.
And then fade them in and be like, oh, just go for smoke. So I'm not much of a DJ. But we had another song that was popular on BFM called Tit Fuck.
Tit Fuck. How did that go?
I can't remember. I'll have to pull it out. I'll have to see if I can.
I'll be in the archives at BFM.
Titty fucking year. It's all everywhere. All everywhere. Titty fucking. That was my past, God.
What are some of the things that...
Sorry. Are you stoned?
No, this is like cracking me up. What are some of the things that helped you get through your toughest times? And I'm not laughing at the question.
Toughest times. Resilience. When you're down, knowing you're down and working yourself way back. I think I'm stoned. Working yourself up.
Yeah.
Resilience. Family. I've had some dark times, bro.
Yeah.
I've been down that well of darkness. But then I'm like a little critter. Like I stick to the side and I climb my fucking way up like this. And then I come back to the light and I'm like, I'm here, bitches. I'm here.
Man, I'm going to have a small one now.
My goodness.
It's too early for me.
This is so...
Thank you, Anika.
Don't give me any more. Yeah. I've got to pick my kids up.
This is your last one then.
Okay. They're probably used to me being turning up pissed anyway. Just joking. God.
See you at the bottom.
See you at the bottom.
Shit.
This definitely makes you feel very wild.
Are some of the songs on your playlist you run to?
Oh, where's my phone? I don't even remember. I'm listening to Tory Kingy's new album at the moment. All Your Ships Have Sailed.
Man, that dude.
You know
what he's up to, eh?
Ten albums in 10 years.
Yeah. And I heard from one of the band members, he's already got 3 in the bag.
I know. A folk album, but I don't know the other two.
One's hip hop.
Don't know the other two.
Maybe. By the way, I'm drinking her proportions.
Yeah.
It's time for that cover buzz.
Hey, it's time for cover buzz.
Tim Finn or Dave Dobbin?
Dave Dobbin.
Why?
So is Tim. I love his songs.
Okay, cool. If you had to invent a conspiracy theory, what would that be?
Well, aliens, but there are aliens, so it's not a conspiracy theory.
Cool, I'm with that.
Kia ora.
Who is one Kiwi artist's music you can't stand?
I'm not gonna answer that, no way.
No.
Who can you not stand?
Eat a dick.
Your fucking fuck face. Who's that?
Don't even worry.
Who can't I stand? God, these are such a long list. No, just jokes. I love all Kiwi music. Yeah. Except for now.
Oh, that's cool.
Nah.
Who did you vote for?
Vote for Labour Green.
Let's go.
Labour Green.
Okay, you get Kohard $50,000 for being a GC. What are you spending it on?
I'm giving it away. I'm giving it to people who need it children who don't get food.
Cool. Beautiful.
I'll keep 20 though for my drug habit.
Yo.
Water, kids.
What's the most outrageous thing you've done ever?
Oh, I can't say it on here. Oh, okay. But it does involve penis and vagina and another penis and another two vaginas.
Orgy.
And maybe, yeah.
Nice. And
it hurt the next day.
Don't worry, we cut it out.
No, leave it in.
Okay, sweet. And saying that, sis, thank you so much for joining me. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
It's been a good time, not a long time. Hopefully next time. No, jokes.
I love your dreadlocks.
Oh, thanks.
How many kutus do you have?
Only three species.
Kia ora, brother. You're amazing.
Thank you so much. Before we wrap this up, is there anything you want to say? Any advice you want to give?
Or? No, I just want to say thanks for having me on
thank
your show.
You.
And you're really beautiful.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah, I think it's the eyes. But we have the same nose. Like, look, go like this to the camera.
Wait,
and then,
were you adopted?
Look, put your nose on my nose. See? I try.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining me. It's a pleasure.
Thanks.
I love your music. I love what you're about.
Thank you.
And keep being a mana wahine and representing for our people. So, yeah.
Could I be in one of your songs?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I'll sing for you.
Can we do it like a little... Can we legit try and jam sometime?
Yeah, okay.
Like, we don't have to record, like...
I've got a busy schedule, though.
Ah, okay.
Could you babysit my kids while we jam?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Sweet. I've been feeling